Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. I'm very glad to welcome you to the Mother Church of Australia, St. Mary's Cathedral, Sydney. This cathedral is dedicated under the title of the Immaculate Mother of God, Help of Christians. That dedication to Our Lady as Help of Christians is itself a reminder to us of the confidence we should have in the intercession of the Blessed Virgin Mary. Great things, victories of many kinds, have been achieved through the Rosary prayed with faith and trust. Great things, miracles of many kinds, and not just in faraway places, but here in this city. 200 years ago, when the Mass and sacraments were denied to the Catholic people in this land through the absence of any priest, it was the Rosary which kept the mysteries and truths of the Incarnation alive in the hearts and minds of the faithful, helping them to persevere and grow in faith, hope, and love. In every stage of the Church's life, we have known the maternal care of the Blessed Virgin Mary, who leads us to her Divine Son and says, "Do whatever he tells you." In recent times, Catholics in every place and every state of life have felt drawn again to seek Our Lady's help as we grapple with problems, difficulties, and even threats to faith, to family life, worries, doubts, and scandals within the Church caused by the failings, sins, and crimes of numbers even of her pastors. There have been a number of initiatives around the world to encourage Catholics to pray the Holy Rosary together, especially on this day. And I'm pleased that here at St. Mary's Cathedral we've been able to link in with those initiatives today. As we commemorate today Our Lady of the Rosary, we will pray the Rosary with the particular intentions of family and the rekindling of faith and the sanctification of the Church and her clergy. I'm convinced this is an important and fruitful way of responding to all the problems that are so apparent. Of course, we must actively work in society, in families, and in the Church to foster the fullness of faith in Christ and to address issues of abuse, cover-up, and failures of every kind. But we must also pray, and pray well. And while as individuals there may be limits on what we can achieve visibly, there are no limits on what we might achieve through an alliance of prayer together, aided by the intercession of the Mother of God. As to the practicality of how we will pray the Rosary today, we'll pray the traditional joyful, sorrowful, and glorious mysteries. Each mystery will be introduced by a short passage from the Holy Scriptures, and we'll alternate leading and responding to the prayers. The first, third, and fifth mysteries of each set will be led by this side and responded by that side. And the second and fourth mysteries will be led by that side and responded by that side. And following the recommendation recently of Pope Francis, we'll begin now with the prayer Subtur Presidium. Together, we fly to thy patronage, O Holy Mother of God. Despise not our petitions in our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and blessed Virgin. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. The joyful mysteries, the first joyful mystery, the Annunciation.
The angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth to a virgin betrothed to a man named Joseph of the house of David, and the virgin's name was Mary. He went in and said to her, "Rejoice, so highly favored, the Lord is with you." She was deeply disturbed by these words and asked herself what this greeting could mean. But the angel said to her, "Mary, do not be afraid. You have won God's favor. Listen, you are to conceive and bear a son, and you must name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his ancestor David. He will rule over the house of Jacob forever, and his reign will have no end." Mary said to the angel, "But how can this come about, since I am a virgin?" "The Holy Spirit will come upon you," the angel answered, "and the power of the Most High will cover you with its shadow. And so the child will be holy and will be called Son of God. Know this too, your kinswoman Elizabeth has, in her old age, herself conceived a son, and she, whom people called barren, is now in her sixth month, for nothing is impossible to God." "I am the handmaid of the Lord," said Mary. "Let what you have said be done to me." And the angel left her.
Our Father.
Forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, and lead all souls to heaven, especially those in most need of your mercy. The second joyful mystery, the Visitation. Mary set out and went as quickly as she could to a town in the hill country of Judah. She went into Zechariah's house and greeted Elizabeth. Now, as soon as Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the child leapt in her womb, and Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit. She gave a loud cry and said, "Of all women, you are the most blessed, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. Why should I be honored with a visit from the mother of my Lord? For the moment your greeting reached my ears, the child in my womb leapt for joy. Yes, blessed is she who believed that the promise made her by the Lord would be fulfilled."
Our Father, it's this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
The third joyful mystery, the birth of Jesus. Now, when the angels had gone from them into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has made known to us." So they hurried away and found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in the manger. When they saw the child, they repeated what they had been told about him, and everyone who heard it was astonished at what the shepherds had to say. As for Mary, she treasured all these things and pondered them in her heart. And the shepherds went back, glorifying and praising God for all that they had heard and seen. It was exactly as they had been told.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Souls to heaven, especially those who most need your mercy.
The fourth joyful mystery, the presentation of Jesus. When the day came for them to be purified as laid down by the law of Moses, the parents of Jesus took him to Jerusalem to present him to the Lord, observing what stands written in the law of the Lord. Every firstborn male must be consecrated to the Lord, and also to offer in sacrifice, in accordance with what is said in the law of the Lord, a pair of turtle doves or two young pigeons. Now in Jerusalem there was a man named Simeon. He was an upright and devout man. He looked forward to Israel's comforting, and the Holy Spirit rested on him. It had been revealed to him by the Holy Spirit that he would not see death until he had set eyes on the Christ of the Lord. Prompted by the Spirit, he came to the temple, and when the parents brought in the child Jesus to do for him what the law required, he took him into his arms, and he blessed God and said, "Now, Master, you can let your servant go in peace, just as you promised."
Us from evil. Amen. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
the fifth joyful mystery, the finding of the child Jesus in the temple. 3 days later, they found him in the temple, sitting among the doctors, listening to them and asking them questions. And all those who heard him were astounded at his intelligence and his replies. They were overcome when they saw him, and his mother said to him, "My child, why have you done this to us? See how worried your father and I have been looking for you." "Why were you looking for me?" he replied. "Did you not know that I must be busy with my father's affairs?" But they did not understand what he meant. He then went down with them and came to Nazareth and lived under their authority. His mother stored up all these things in her heart.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Lead all souls to heaven, especially those who most need thy mercy. The first sorrowful mystery, the agony in the garden. He then left the upper room to make his way as usual to the Mount of Olives, with the disciples following. When they reached the place, he said to them, "Pray not to be put to the test." Then he withdrew from them about a stone's throw away and knelt down and prayed, saying, "Father, if you are willing, take this cup away from me. Nevertheless, let your will be done, not mine." Then an angel appeared to him coming from heaven to give him strength. In his anguish, he prayed even more earnestly, and his sweat fell to the ground like great drops of blood. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Lead all souls to heaven, especially those who most need of thy mercy. The second sorrowful mystery, the scourging at the pillar. So Pilate, anxious to placate the crowd, released Barabbas for them and, having ordered Jesus to be scourged, handed him over to be crucified. Our Father, who art in heaven, The third sorrowful mystery, the crowning with thorns. The governor's soldiers took Jesus with them into the praetorium and collected the whole cohort round him. Then they stripped him and made him wear a scarlet cloak. And having twisted some thorns into a crown, they put this on his head and placed a reed in his right hand. To make fun of him, they knelt to him, saying, "Hail, King of the Jews!" And they spat on him and took the reed and struck him on the head with it. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. The fourth sorrowful mystery, the carrying of the cross. They then took charge of Jesus, and carrying his own cross, he went out of the city to the place of the skull, or as it was called in Hebrew, Golgotha. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. The fifth sorrowful mystery, the crucifixion. When they reached the place called the Skull, they crucified Jesus there, and the criminals also, one on the right, the other on the left. Jesus said, "Father, forgive them. They do not know what they are doing." Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
The first glorious mystery, the resurrection. On the first day of the week, at the first sign of dawn, the women went to the tomb with the spices they had prepared. They found that the stone had been rolled away from the tomb, but on entering discovered that the body of the Lord Jesus was not there. As they stood there, not knowing what to think, two men in brilliant clothes suddenly appeared at their side. Terrified, the women lowered their eyes. But the two men said to them, "Why look among the dead for someone who is alive? He is not here. He is risen. Remember what he told you when he was still in Galilee, that the Son of Man had to be handed over into the power of sinful men and be crucified and rise again on the third day." And they remembered his words.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
especially those who most need your mercy.
The second glorious mystery, the Ascension. And so the Lord Jesus, after he had spoken to them, was taken up into heaven. There, at the right hand of God, he took his place. While they, going out, preached everywhere, the Lord working with them and confirming the word by the signs that accompanied it.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
The third glorious mystery, the descent of the Holy Spirit. When Pentecost Day came round, the apostles had all met in one room, when suddenly they heard what sounded like a powerful wind from heaven, the noise of which filled the entire house in which they were sitting, and something appeared to them that seemed like tongues of fire. These separated and came to rest on the head of each of them. They were all filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak foreign languages as the Spirit gave them the gift of speech.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
The fourth glorious mystery, the Assumption. The daughter of the King is clothed with splendor, her robes embroidered with pearls set in gold. She is led to the King with her maiden companions. They are escorted amid gladness and joy. They pass within the palace of the King.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
All souls to heaven, especially those who most need your mercy. The fifth glorious mystery, the coronation. Who is this, arising like the dawn, fair as the moon, resplendent as the sun, terrible as an army with banners?
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell. Lead all souls to heaven, especially those in most need of thy mercy. Hail, Holy Queen, Mother of Mercy. Hail, our life, our sweetness, and our hope. To thee do we cry, poor banished children of Eve. To thee do we send up our sighs, mourning and weeping this valley of tears. Turn then, most gracious advocate, thine eyes of mercy towards us. And after this our exile, show unto us the blessed fruit of thy womb, Jesus. O clement, O loving, O sweet Virgin Mary. Let us pray. O God, whose only begotten Son, by his life, death, and resurrection, has purchased for us the rewards of eternal life, grant, we beseech thee, that meditating upon these mysteries of the most holy Rosary of the Blessed Virgin Mary, we may both imitate what they contain and obtain what they promise, through the same Christ our Lord. Amen. May the divine assistance remain always with us. May the souls of the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. The Lord be with you. Be near to those who call on you, O Lord, and graciously grant your protection to all who place their hope in your mercy, that they may remain faithful in holiness of life, and having enough for their needs in this world, they may be made full heirs of your promise for eternity, through Christ our Lord. Holy Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our safeguard against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do you, O Prince of the Heavenly Host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who wander through the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you always.